Hey guys, and welcome to FM Underdog's latest series. It's taken me by surprise, this. FM14, obviously, beta is out. I thought, let's have a look, do a little save for myself, play a few games, you know, do a little career just for myself. But I'm actually really enjoying it, so I thought I'm going to share it with you. I'm in the second season now, so I'll have to recap the first season for you. And then we've got a live game against Gloucester at home to show you. So as you can see, we've come in and started with Whitehawk, a bit of an underdog. This save's just me playing it as a manager, so there's no guarantees I'll be staying with Whitehawk. If I get job offers, I may move on. Just bear me a second, I'm just going to put my phone on aeroplane mode, so you'll probably get a bit of interference while I do it. But just to stop all the major interference going through. So, last season, we're obviously in the Skrill South. Last season, we lost in the playoff final to Ebbsfleet 2-0 or 2-1. We led the league for a hell of a long time last season. We scored a lot of goals, as you can see, but our defence went to pot in the second half of the season, and at one point we dropped right down to ninth. We managed to fight back up to third, but it was disappointing as we led the league for a long time. So yeah, it was a good season but disappointing. Underdogs came out of nowhere basically, and you know, we did really well to get there. This season, this season we are second at the moment. Had a bit of a dodgy start because we lost a hell of a lot of players. Finances at the club are terrible. Lost a lot of players. Managed to keep hold of my main threats. I'll show you in a minute. We started really dodgily. I'll show you some of the fixtures in a minute. Some of the results even. There we are. So we started 3-0 up against Hayes and Yedding, drew 3-0. Then we lost 2-0 to Dover, beat Tonbridge 3-1, 2-2 draw of Brackley, 2-3 defeat to Gloucester, who we're playing next. Then we were on a bit of a run, beating St Albans 2-1, Bromley 6-3, Burgess Hill 3-0 in the second qualifying round of the FA Cup. Haven't won Waterlooville 4-2. Then we let slip a 3-0 lead against Hornchurch to draw 3-0. We do that a lot, let big leads slip. Beat Faversham only 1-0, last minute goal, I think it was. It was a late goal from Gargan. Then we beat Western Supermare 2-1. 3-0 draw with Bishop Stortford before being beaten in the next round. They were relegated from our league last year. Then we've gone on a bit of a three-game win run again, with wins at Concord, Bath and Sutton in the Cup, before being pummeled by league leaders Boreham and Wood 4-0, then 3-1 to Dorchester, before beating Staines 2-1 and losing 5-2 at home to second place Eastbourne Borough. Then beating Concord 5-0 in the Cup before losing 2-1 to Basingstoke. Then just absolutely poleaxing Chelmsford 6-1 before losing 2-1 to Maidenhead. Then Billericay we beat 2-0, 0-0 with Farnborough before being knocked out in the next in the replay of the second round of the FA Trophy. And now we're on a winning streak. We've beaten Sutton 6-3, Dover 4-1. Hazing Yedding 1-0, Brackley 3-0, Tunbridge Angels 1-0, and St Albans 4-1 last time out. So that's that. We're going to come in with a live game against Gloucester in a minute. This is the squad as it stands. A lot of loan players because of our finances. I've had to loan a lot of players. So we've got Lewis Carey on loan from Wickham. Not the best keeper in the world, but he's doing all right at this level. We've also got Aaron Oakley from Swindon. Again, not the best players in the world, but they're doing all right for me. This guy's been decent from Luton. On loan from Luton, Matt Robinson. We've also got this lad, Aguiarqua on loan from Southend. He's done all right since coming in. This guy's just joined us from Dagenham on loan, so not really looked at him very much. And then we've got Jack Payne, who's on loan from Southend. He's been all right for us this season. A couple of youth players in there, a couple of free transfers that we've picked up. Players that I would recommend to people at this level and possibly the level above: Bismarck on the far. He's been very good for us. You signed him on a free last season. And Jake Robinson, former Football League player, he's been decent for us. He was there when I got here, as was Sam Gargan, who gets a hell of a lot of goals at this level, so not worth a punt in the conference. About 32 goals for us that season. And his partner in crime, Danny Mills, also a goal machine at this level. Got 27 last year, 15 this year. And I always liked to sign this fellow ever since I signed him on my Alfreton save last year and the year before. Kiernan Hughes-Mason. Not as prolific as he has been for me on other ones, but he's come in and done well. Came in on a free after a loan spell last season. So those are the players, and then there's just a few more. The turnaround, as I say, in players in the summer was quite substantial. Come on, fella. I can never remember where it is on this one. It's all a bit different around. But those are the players in, as you can see. A lot of players came in. A lot of players left. Barry Quinn signed last season, but he's gone. Giuseppe Sol signed a new contract. Taylor. Those have all gone now. Obviously, it's the outgoings. But they had some very good players for this level. And then last season, there was a few. And these guys came in and left all in one season. And as you can see, we've brought in a lot of loan signings last season. Quite some decent ones as well. It's just a shame we couldn't get some of them to stay, really. Jordan Robertson was really good for us. Recommending to people, as Kenza Lee. He was really good. And then this season, where's he gone? The guy from Adebayo Aziz, who I brought in on loan from Charlton. They won't let him have us back. Well, let us have him back, sorry. But he got 9 in 13, so he did really well for us, to be fair. So I was impressed with that. And that's it really for the minute. Finances, as I say, are terrible. I think we're about £500,000-£600,000 in debt. Possibly, it might be less than that now. No, £438,000 in debt. We are over our wage budget at the minute, but there's not much I can do really. If we want to be able to try and compete and do well in the league, we're having to go over it a little bit, which is what I did with Hinkley and Alfreton in my first couple of seasons. So we're hopefully going to go up this season. Hopefully we can put the playoff defeat to the back of our mind from last season and push on this season and hopefully go up. We're on a good run, but this is a video which probably means we will lose. That's generally the way it goes when I do videos. So let's have a look who he suggests. I do play Kieran at the back quite a lot, right back a lot. He does quite well there. Mills on there, you there. Yeah, I think that's all right. This young lad, Bobby Jones, one of my youth players who's come through. My youth players are not very good at all, but he's done quite well for us so far. I quite like him. So I try to involve him when I can. And Barry Purdy, he came in when an injury is picked up by my keeper. I do have another goalkeeper. He's currently in the under-21s, though. He made too many mistakes when he played. So I thought, sod it. You know me, guys, if you watch these videos and follow me on Twitter, I love to take a risk. Threw him in. He did really well, to be fair. He makes some fantastic saves. Lets in some daft goals, but he makes some fantastic saves. He's conceded 5-4, which isn't bad, really. 9-6 in all competitions. So, yeah, he's had a few games. But we're going to take him off the bench for now for today's game and pop Jonesy on. Robbo, yep. Yeah, we'll go with that. This guy took some convincing. He's one that my director of football, Roger Ashby, brought in. He took some convincing for me, really. But, you know, he's done all right. fairly pleased with him since he had a bit of a dodgy start. But, you know, I'm happy with him now. I'm doing this in the classic 2D because 3D would just lag horrendously on my computer for videos. Oh, there you go. No, not responding. Happens every now and again. I need to get a new laptop. I was hoping to have one by now, but life's got in the way. So this will be the first game on video of the FM14 season for me. Like I say, this isn't the main underdog. Say the main underdog one was going to be with Telford, but I've decided to wait till the full game's out with the editor and wait till we've got the lower leagues added, and I'm going to go from the, you know, one of those divisions all the way through this time. So keep an eye out for that when it comes, but until then, hopefully this will whet your appetite for some more. So as you can see, we've got a lot of goals in us really, as a team, so hopefully we can continue our good form. Let me just check. Yeah, the volume's off. Very good. I'll slow this down as well, so I've got on a high speed for off for when I play it without you fellas watching. So as usual with video, nothing's happened so far. What a load of old tripe. Oh, here we go. A lot of goals I've noticed, like this one now. Oh no, he's missed. A lot of goals come from goal kicks. The keeper kicks it out, gets knocked back towards him and ends up in the back of the net half the time. Oh no, Robbo's picked up an injury. Jake Robinson, that sucks. Right, Millsy Poos, you go up top. And Hughes Mason can jump on there. All right, on this one as well, if you watch my other videos, my Alfreton series, Hughes Mason, I played a lot up the middle. He seems to be better on the wing on this one than he does up the middle. So, you know, hopefully he can get us a goal or two in this game. But yeah, he scores a lot more from the wing than he does at the middle on this, I've noticed. Well, that was a pants first half. Just calmly, I know a lot of you will be keen to avenge what happened when we played them last time. Go out there and express yourselves. Ooh, that's a new one, ain't it? So I hope everybody's enjoying the new game. I know it's a bit frustrating when the beta first comes out. I wasn't actually going to get it. I thought, nah, I'm not going to bother, because last year I hated the beta so much. Or beta, however you want to say it. I hated it so much. Every time there was a cross, the ball went in the back of the net and all that sort of stuff. It was really annoying. Some of those things are still happening on this one. Well, they were, until they did a little update, and it seems to have ironed itself out a bit now. Right, so we're not doing very well at all in this match, are we? Mr. Fit, you can jump in for Payne, and I don't really want to chop the bat too much, but Hickford can come on. One of my threes that I picked up in the summer. This has been a boring game, I do apologise, guys. Some key highlights, but there's not been many, clearly. This is terrible. Terrible stuff for you guys to witness. A 0-0 draw on the first video of the series. Yeah, that's the end of that. What a load of old shite that was. Well, we should be winning. Oh, you do it, because I'll put the wrong one. Oh, Aaron Oakley looks stressed. Oh, boo-hoo, Pillock. Well, as that was such a crapper, I suppose I might as well throw in Bromley at home for you, so that you'll probably see us lose that one, because it's the second game in a week, second game in short succession, and with no fitness coaches, poor facilities and so on, it's hard sometimes for us to keep these lads going for so long. I mean, look, these guys need a rest already. Robbo, oh, he's out for 4 or 5 weeks. That's a kick in the kicking the kahunas right there. That sucks. That really does suck. Yeah, we have lost the key man. Thanks for rubbing it in. So, I'll skip through that. I'll show you the tactics quickly. People always like to know what tactics people are playing. I tend to rotate this sometimes on what the guy who's in that position is best at. So it can be poacher, defensive forward, target man, it swats around. But we go with a flat back four, box to box midfielder, ball winning midfielder, two wingers, advance forward, and then whatever I do with that one there. My team instructions: retain possession, shorter passing, pass into space, run at defence, hassle opponents, use tight marking at a much higher tempo. Those are my things. I do concede a lot still, but I do score a lot normally as well. So and then we're attacking and very fluid. The other formation, never use it, so I'm not really going to go into that. I think I've used it once and we got absolutely walloped, and I've just left it on there to try another formation just in case one game I decide to pull it out of the blue and to try and catch somebody off guard. So we've got Bromley next, who are a good team at this level. I think they came down from the Scrub Prem. No, they didn't. I'm making that up. I can't remember. But they're a good team anyway. Trying to loan David Martin from Luton. Well, what do they want? They expect a monthly contribution. Key players, future fee. Monthly fee of £700. Go on, we'll give him that. Because we need a replacement for Robbo. So we'll give him that. I do like how you can do it in the email on this now. You don't have to click on different screens and all that guff just to sign a player or loan a player or whatever. But I've accepted the offer for him anyway, so that's a bit of a start. A bit of a drop down, no disrespect to Whitehawk, a bit of a drop down for Davy Martin, really, I think. I remember seeing him play for Millwall against Crewe a couple of times. He always looked decent. He should do well at our level. He's got quite decent stats, I think. He won't sign in time for Bromley, I don't think, though. But you never know. You never know. We do have a lot of loan players, though. More than our allowance. You'll have five in the team and on the bench. Five to be involved in the matchday squad. So Portsmouth tried to loan Bentley. Oh, our game's been postponed. Well, that's a bit of a bumhole. Right, but what I'll do is, guys, I'll pause it and we'll go to our next game. And we're back. We're going. I don't know why I'm on this page. I clicked on it by accident. But isn't that a lovely page for you all? So, Hamilton Waterlooville. Let me just check this is recording. I'm not just talking to myself. Yes, it is. Winner. So, Hamilton Waterlooville. I think it's a very even stretch between us. Got some cracking players. Blanchett, a former Crewe player. They've got Pele, the former West Brom player. He's a very good player at this level. Sean Jeffers, former Coventry striker, he's a decent player on FM at the lower levels as well. So, also David Martin's loan deal didn't go through because we could not afford to stump up the cash to complete it. But we do have, apart from Robbo, a full strength squad. So hopefully we can go out there and do the business and get some goals for you guys. Although, after the last game, I'm not holding my breath too much. So, hopefully, though, like I say, we can get a win today. That'll be sweet. Predictions, Whitehawk are on a high, and that form should be enough to get them victory today. Wouldn't be so sure about that. Would not be so sure at all. I hope so. So calmly, no, passionately. We've been on a good run, impress me. And then you can do the second bit. They listen keenly. So here we go. Let's hope there's more highlights than that. Wow, what a highlight to start off with. Somebody kicking the ball out of play. Oh, well, we're doing better already. We've got one highlight at least. I'm not happy about this though. I'm not happy with this at all. Dakalim. Oh, poor defending. Oh, an unbelievable miss. Unbelievable, Jeff. Come on, get in there. Robinson, no, go on. Mills, surely that was offside. Danny Mills, he loves a goal. He loves a goal. Yeah, if you could sign him and Gargan on this when you start up a save, they get goals, believe you me. That's his 19th for the season. I don't know if that's right, though, because sometimes if he scores again, I noticed, but I don't know if he's done it since the update. Go on. Oh, go on. Oh, but, like, he'd score a goal and it'd say 19th goal of the season. Then he'd get another two, so he'd get a hat-trick. It'd still say 19th of the season. Oh, Gargan out wide again. Go on. Go on. Go! Oh, Moses Swaybu. He's been in my bad books a bit lately, the captain. Club captain. He's been, sort of, when I watched the 3D games, he's been making some terrible errors. So he's been away from the first team. Go on. Oh, he's got another. Oh, he's winning his way back into my happy books now. I warn you now, though, I must be managing them very similar to Crew, who I support, because I've seen Crew 3-0 up and draw 3-0 or lose 4-3 before, and that's exactly what this Whitehawk team has in their locker. We can be 3 or 4-0 up and still end up with a point or a defeat. 4! Mills with his second! We are ripping Waterlooville to shreds at the minute. And that's his 20th of the season, it's at the bottom. But yeah, and they've sorted that out because it says 20th there as well. So that's one little dinky glitch that's sorted. So I'm happy with this. Before, this is far better than the tripe you saw in the last match. Go on, Mills hat trick! Can we play you every week? That's a superb first half. I remember before the update as well. Go on, Gargan. 6, go on. Oh, I'm over. Oh, good. Before the update, there was a game when I was winning, last season, when I was winning 5-0 with like 15 minutes to go. And then there was 4 highlights in a row, all for them, and every single one of them went in. I don't know if that was a glitch or if it was just terrible defending on our part. Well, keep it up. I don't want to say one of those you might be winning, but don't take it for granted ones, because that normally pees them off and I end up conceding a lot in the second half. Oh, beautiful play. Oh, lucky. Shoot, Swaybu, shoot. So, we'll wait till just after the hour mark and we give a couple of the fringe players on the bench a run out. I think. Da, 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 da. Benjamin Beckles. He's been a naughty boy. Right. Rosie, I don't really have anybody to bring on for you. I can't really give you a rest today. Give Bobby a go in the centre for Robinson. Notice I haven't got a striker on the bench. That's a bit of a schoolboy out. Well, Mills, who's got his hat-trick, can come off for Smith, and we'll leave one just in case of injury or somebody gets sent off. Normally when I make all three substitutions at this point in the game, a couple of injuries occur or somebody gets sent off, some stupid tripe and I'm stuck. The second half's been a serious anticlimax. Oh, Jamie Smith picked up a knock, but he still scores from a free kick. What a ledge. 6-0. Well, this has made up for the crappy first game anyway. So we've got 6 on the card. I'm gonna risk it and make the final substitution. We'll take Oakley off and bring the young Cypriot Andis Nicolaou on. Just for a run out, Cypriot under 21, I'll have you know. Free transfer. This will be the last highlight of the game. The rundown highlight, as I call it. And that's it. A nice 6-0 win away from home at Havant and Waterlooville. Passionately kiss my players. I mean, congratulate my players. And that's the end of that. So a nice 6-0 win. First game is a bit of a bummer. 5 points off the top, 10 points safety gap between us and Gloucester, who are just outside the playoffs, so that's decent. Got us a 9-point gap between Bath and them. That's pretty decent. And then at the bottom, St Albans slipping slowly away from the league. So hopefully we can keep this form up and make it into the wonderful Skrill Premier League. I keep going to say Blue Square Premier League. So thank you for watching, guys. Hopefully this will whet your appetite for a bit more. Don't know how frequent these are going to be, and like I say, don't know how long I'm going to be with Whitehawk for. Could stay with them for the entirety of the series, or could move if a job offer or an interview comes in. Please like, please subscribe, please share, and spread the word that the Underdog is back. Thanks very much, guys.